It all started right here. Where else could it happen? New York, capital of the universe. The chessboard destiny chose for the last big game. I was just another pawn living my pawn's life. Until that night, when my life descended into chaos.
What have I done? I didn't want... It was like a dream. Quick. I've got to get out of here before somebody comes in here. Knife. I've got to get rid of it. It's barred up. I can't get out this way. Thank you. out of order.
Sir.
The waitress. She noticed something. I'm done for. Yes?
I think that you might have forgotten to pay your bill.
Oh, yes, of course. Excuse me. The bill for the meal. How could I forget that? Quick, before somebody finds the body. To get out of this neighborhood before the police get here. Far away to walk. I have to find another way to get back home.
Nobody goes anywhere. A crime has just been committed. I'm going to have to ask you to stay calm and wait here for the police to arrive and check your IDs.
Dog's dining, that's it. Why do they always wait for me to go on duty before they start killing each other in the middle of the night?
Tyler, somebody gets murdered every day in New York.
But especially when I'm on night duty. It's as if every psycho in the city has it in for me.
If you want a bitch, do it inside. That way I don't have to freeze to death listening to it.
You're the boss, Carla.
In 5 years on the force, I've seen some murders. But you never really get used to death. You just learn to live with it, that's all. I still don't know if it was fatigue, or cold, or something else. But I clearly remember the bad feeling I got when I walked into that restaurant, as if some part of me already knew that this time, something was different. How's it going, McCarthy?
Evening, Inspector. I've been waiting for you. Hey, Tyler.
Hey, Martin.
So, what happened?
Homicide. I found the body in the toilets. I had to go before I went home.
Do we have a suspect?
A client left just before I found the body.
How was the victim killed?
With a blade, from what I could gather. But we should wait for the autopsy.
Who is the victim?
His name was, John Winston. A regular here at the restaurant. Kate knew him. She could tell you more.
Were there other customers in the restaurant at the time?
Yeah, two other guys. I let them go home. I wrote down their names and numbers in case you wanted to question them.
Is the body still there?
The boys from the morgue were waiting for you to get here before moving it. Nobody's been in the toilet since we found the body.
Is that the waitress over there?
Yeah, Kate Morrison. I think that you should interrogate her. If you don't mind me saying, go easy on her, Inspector. She's still in a state of shock.
Which table was the suspect sitting at?
Oh, he was sitting at that table over there.
Thanks for your help, Martin. It's late. I think you can go home and get some sleep.
I'm gonna wait until you're finished with Kate, if you don't mind. I want to make sure she gets home okay.
Huh. Here's his fork, but where's the knife? Well, well, the coffee's not on the bill. This is his. It's a pretty weird book for a killer to be reading. Garrett, there's a book under this table. Why don't you check it out for prints?
You got it, Carla.
A cup of coffee and a soft drink? That's weird. He's a caffeine addict, or else he wasn't alone. Gotta remember to check with the waitress on that. Blood on the mop. The killer must have used it to clean up the mess. Why would he risk getting caught to do that? Several wounds on the left side of the chest, in the area of the heart. They appear to be knife wounds.
No trace of a struggle. Looks like the guy was taken totally by surprise. Unless there's a gang running around hiding bloody knives in toilets, I think I might have found the murder weapon.
Great. Tell Garrett, have him check for prints on the handle.
Okay. Bizarre.
What?
Well, he still has his credit card and $100 in cash on him. I guess the killer wasn't after his money.
Do you know if anyone has contacted the family?
Not as far as I know. Oh, right. I get it. I'll take care of it.
Just what exactly are you doing, Tyler?
I'm checking for clues. What do you think?
Tyler?
What? This is a restroom, isn't it?
No, this is a crime scene.
It's cool. I'm done. Must be all that coffee I've been drinking to try and stay awake. Hey, Garrett. Carla wants you to verify two or three things. Don't worry, I wrote it all down on this paper so you wouldn't forget.
I had a feeling that Carla was gonna keep us up a little longer.
Kate? I'm Inspector Carla Valenti. I'm in charge of the investigation here. Would you mind answering a few questions?
No. Go ahead.
Did you know the victim well?
John was a regular. He came every Monday. He always ordered the same thing and left a nice tip.
Can you tell me anything about the customer who left just before they discovered the body?
He was just a normal guy. I didn't really pay any attention to him.
Could anyone else have come in?
No, I don't think so. You can only get in the front door. If somebody else had come in, I would have seen them.
What was the man doing before the murder happened?
He was there for a while. He was reading, I think.
That book under the table must have been his. Was John here alone? Did he speak with anyone?
John always came alone. We chatted a bit, the weather, his job, the usual stuff. He never talked to anybody else.
Did you get the impression that John and the suspect knew each other?
No, I don't think they did know each other. The man had already been here a while when John came in. They didn't talk to each other. No, I'm almost certain that John didn't know him.
Can you tell me what you saw?
There weren't that many people tonight. It's usually pretty calm during the week. I was just chatting with Martin at the bar. I didn't even see John get up. Oh my God.
You have to try to be strong, Kate. I know that this has been a shock for you, but you're the only one who can help us find the suspect.
My shift was almost over. I was just chatting with Martin at the bar. John got up and went to the restroom. The man must have followed him. When he came back out, I noticed that he hadn't paid his bill. I'm careful, because that happens a lot here, people forgetting to pay their bill.
What happened next?
The man came back, he paid his bill and left. It wasn't until Martin found John's body that I realized...
There was a cup of coffee on his table. Do you remember whether he was the one who ordered it?
A cup of coffee? No, I'm certain he didn't order any coffee.
Did you happen to notice anything strange about the suspect's behavior before he went into the restroom?
No. You, wait. Yes. I remember something. I came back at one point just to check whether he needed anything. He didn't answer me. He just stared straight ahead. It was weird. I didn't push it. I thought maybe this guy is a little crazy. God. I had only known.
Do you think that you would recognize the suspect?
I'll never forget that face.
Perfect. Do you think that you could come down to the station tomorrow and help us construct a likeness of the killer?
Yeah. I'll do whatever you think I can to help catch him.
Thank you very much for your help, Kate.
I hope you find the bastard who did it. People like that just don't deserve to live.
I promise you, we'll do everything in our power to find him. Go home now and try to get some sleep. Martin will make sure you get home okay.
Good night.
Hey, Garrett. Hey, Frank. How's it going?
Hey, Carla.
Hey, Carla.
So, you guys find anything?
We took some samples here and there. We're almost finished. We were just waiting for you before we took the body away.
Tyler, I'm gonna take a look outside. Killer is wounded. A taxi. The murderer might have come or gone in a taxi. I'm gonna check on the destinations of taxis leaving this area.